Hey there, friends. Welcome back to the YouTube channel for the First United Methodist Church in Orange, California. Great to see you. My name is Pastor Bill Johnson, and this is another daily episode of We Are the Church. Very happy Thursday to you, friends. Great to be with you today. I hope that your week has been unfolding in just the right way. And if you made some mistakes, I hope that you already are sensing God's forgiveness for those. Hey, today I'm going to be reading from the sixth chapter of the Gospel of Matthew. And these verses are part of what we call the Sermon on the Mount. It's a collection of various teachings of Jesus on piety and treatment of others and how not to judge. This is all collected in chapters 5, 6, and 7 of the Gospel of Matthew, and it's in a setting where Jesus sat down with his disciples and he taught them. So the speaker in this passage is Jesus, and we are the audience. So let's hear from chapter 6, verse 31 through 33, and Jesus is saying, "Therefore don't worry, saying, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear? For the Gentiles, it's the Gentiles who strive for all of these things, and indeed your heavenly Father knows that you need these things. But strive for the first for the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and then all these other things will be given to you as well." Striving after things that consume us with worry. Friends, I'm blessed to be an Eagle Scout. It was a powerful experience in my young life. And the motto of the scouting program is be prepared. And indeed, the clan motto for the Johnston clan, where some of my heritage, I think, comes, that clan motto was nunquam non paratus, meaning never unprepared. Do you think God was trying to send me a message in my life? Being prepared is a worthy and wise thing to do. When we're heading into a football game, if we're going to play, you're going to want to wear some equipment, so be prepared. And if you're heading out to do other things, going camping in a wilderness, you want to bring some things along that will help you if something should go wrong, that'll ensure your survival. We try to be prepared, but there are people in our lives, and you probably know a few, who have turned worrying into a world-class Olympic sport. It's one thing to be prepared, to have a sense of assurance that if something goes wrong, I can handle it. But it's another thing to just sit and worry and worry and worry. Worry is counterproductive. It steals your energy and it doesn't do anything. Can't even add an inch to the length of your life, according to Jesus. Worrying just tears your heart to shreds, gives you all kinds of physical conditions. It puts the wrong enzymes in our bodies and it makes us sicker, to be quite frank. Worrying is not what Jesus is talking about. Being prepared, especially in the way that Jesus describes it, means being spiritually prepared. Having such a closeness to God in our relationship with God that no matter what happens to us, it's not going to knock us off of our sense of true north. It's not going to destroy our faith, and it's not going to have us being completely disassembled emotionally, mentally, spiritually, physically. Don't worry means top off your spiritual batteries every single day through prayer, through reading of scripture, through showing love toward one another without discrimination toward anyone. Just be prepared to continue living in God on a day-to-day existence. God will lead us into the things that we need. Sometimes we need a bit of a trial to get our motivation going again. And sometimes we need an easy day so that we can rest in the lap of God. So God made the Sabbath and he made 6 days for work. But be prepared for whatever comes today. That's all you need to worry about. And being prepared for us as Christians means being ready to hang on to God as this roller coaster of a ride through this world continues. Be prepared is a way of saying, don't be anxious. God's got the hard stuff. So if we can hang in there with God, then we can meet any circumstance. And that's our word of encouragement for today. Let's be in prayer. Loving God, we thank you for blessing our lives with the opportunity to stay close to you. We thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, for the forgiveness of our sins, and for his call in our lives to share that love that you bring to the world in him with everyone we meet. And so, God, help us to trust in you for the things we need to survive in this world. Steer us away from worry. Give us the gift of faith. Help us to follow you and to trust that you will give everything else to us if we are seeking your kingdom. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, thank you so much for stopping by today. A reminder that you can find We Are the Church every single Monday through Saturday right here on this YouTube channel. And a quick reminder of our three simple rules as you're getting ready to end this video with me. Stay in love with God, do no harm, and do all the good you can. And I'll see you soon.